Facebook just released a new feature called Facebook Reels on iOS and Android devices. If you guys know about Instagram Reels, they're pretty similar to Facebook Reels, obviously, because Facebook owns both Facebook and Instagram. But Facebook Reels now opens a new door for creators to promote their videos on yet another platform. I know I had a ton of success with my podcast repurposing them and turning them into vertical content, and Facebook Reels would be another great place that I could post these, or that you could post these for your project. So today I'm gonna show you how to use the Facebook Reels editor. However, it's incredibly limited. So if you want more control with your videos, I'm gonna teach you how you can edit your vertical videos using our free online video editor, Kapwing, and then just upload them to Facebook Reels so that you can make them whatever you want. Let's get into it. So the first thing you need to do is just download Facebook on your phone. Reels are not yet on desktop at all. You can't watch them, you can't make them. So you have to have it on an iOS device or an Android device. So just make sure to download the app and then open it. And there's a few ways to create Reels. So number one, you can see that there is a reel just under the what's on your mind status update thing. That you can click that and then you can film a reel right in there. Also, you'll see that next to stories below that, there is a reels button that you can then click. And then there is also a create reels button. And you can also watch reels from here as well. Let's go ahead and click the create reels button. And then now you're gonna be taken to the reels camera. So there's a few things that you can do. The most basic one, obviously, is just clicking the button, and then that will record your reels. And you can see how much room you have left to record using the bar up on top. A Facebook reel can only be 30 seconds maximum, so the full bar will be 30 seconds long. If you don't want to keep that clip, you can click the delete button on the left here, and then it will delete. You can discard it and start over. There's also some other things that you can do, include changing the lighting. So at the top, you'll see this little moon, and that's just the normal lighting. If you click it, that's for cloudy lighting, I believe. And then if you click it one more time, then it'll flash and light up the screen a little bit more. So you can see at the bottom of the screen also how many clips you've recorded, and then click those. And then you can choose the clip to edit it if you want. So you can click one of the clips. You can click the reshoot button if you want to redo just one clip. You can also delete the clip and also trim the clip just by clicking the trim button and doing that. And by reshooting, you just click the reshoot button again, and it'll give you the option to reshoot within the same time frame. Now also, if you want to add audio, you can click the audio button, of course, and it'll pull up a bunch of stuff in the audio library. It's pretty comprehensive. So let's say I want like an Ariana Grande song, right? You can see they have a ton of Ariana Grande songs that you can use. So the music library is quite good. So if you want to do that, you can click a song and then pick the portion of the song that you want using this little scroller, and then click done, and then it'll play when you record. You can also click the speed button, and then you can record at different speeds. You can also click the effects tab, and they have a lot of the filters that Instagram has, obviously, because they own Instagram. And it works the same as Instagram filters as well. So you can use any of these ones at the bottom. However, if you don't like any of these, you could scroll all the way to the right and then use the browse effects function and then click it. And then you will see that there is an effect library. However, there's not an actual search bar like there is on Instagram, so you can't search for other effects that you may know of. There's also a timer function, so you can time a countdown, so you can go hands-free, you can record hands-free. And there's also a recording length feature, so if you wanna record hands-free, but you only wanna record, you know, 8 seconds instead of the full 30 seconds, and then you can do that as well just by trimming this down using these sliders, which is a good feature as well. And then lastly, there's the green screen feature, which you can green screen using any of the pictures that they have already in their scenes tab, or you can use your own camera roll and pick a picture, and then I will green screen with a picture of myself at the beach. And then you can record that way by clicking the done button, and then now I can record on this green screen, which is a really helpful feature as well. I used to use this a ton in TikTok. But that's about it. That's about it. The editor is really, really simple. And yeah, you can create reels in here. However, there's not so much you can do. You can't use all the effects that TikTok has or that Instagram Reels has. So it's definitely still something that's probably going to be built out more in the future. When you're done, you can click next, and then you can make any final touches here. So you can add audio again if you didn't add it to begin with. You can also add text, and the way that text works is pretty similar to Instagram. So you can change the text by clicking the button on the right in the little oval, and then you can see that it changes the text, and they look very similar to the Instagram text for stories and things like that. You can also change the color on the left, and use any of these colors. You can also change the alignment, so by clicking these lines right there. You can also change the text wrap, so if you want it to have no background wrap, or if you want it to have a opaque background wrap, or if you want it to have a semi-transparent background wrap. You can also use the trim button, and then you can trim portion of your video. You can't trim individual clips in here, you have to do that previous to this page. And you can also add captions by clicking the bottom button, captions, and then it should automatically subtitle your video, which is really nice. But you can also edit the captions by clicking the edit caption button right here, and you can edit these just by clicking a word and then typing in a new one. Now, if you want, you can save your video here on the left, which is nice because you can't do this on TikTok without a watermark. And you can on Facebook, which so that's you know something that Facebook has going for it. And then when you're ready to post, you can click the next button, and then you can share a description, and you can click who you want to be able to see it here, public, friends, or you know, not showing certain people. And then you can click the share reel button, and then you're all done. If you want to upload a video to Reels instead, you can click the create Reels button, and then on the bottom left, you can upload a Reels this way that's already been edited from your camera roll. So as you can see here, I'm opening it up, and then I have some videos that I could upload this way. It's pretty simple, there's not too much you can do, but I am gonna show you how you can make more custom edits using our free online video editor, Kapwing, because it's pretty limiting on the Facebook Reels editor, and you know you guys want a little bit more control, so I'm gonna show you how to do that now. Okay, hi guys. So the first thing you're gonna do is click the first link in the description. It'll take you to kapwing.com. It's a free online video editor. All you have to do is sign in so that when you export, your video doesn't have a watermark. It's completely free. You can sign up with these options. So then in your workspace, you're going to create new content. And then here you can upload whatever footage that you may have. So I'm gonna upload this video that I am going to make a reel. Now you can see that because I filmed it vertically, it's already in vertical. If yours is a horizontal video, what you can do is just go to the output size and click 9x16. So make sure you click 9x16 and it'll change it to this format. Now first things first, you can see that this video is about 37 seconds, which is too long for Facebook Reels. So I'm going to just cut. You can see that here I start to just say like, and I'm not really sure what I'm saying. To split, you can click the split button right here or the S button on your keyboard. And then you can do that again and then just delete this footage, bring this all down. I'll trim the beginning and ends. And then now you can see that when I pull everything down, it is under 30 seconds. So now I'm happy with that. Now, as I said, Instagram does have a good library of music. However, if there is a specific song that you want to use that is not on there, maybe it's a trending song or something like that, what you can do is you can go to the audio tab on the left here. You can also upload your own sound if you have it downloaded, or you can paste in a link. So if you have a link of like a TikTok or a song that you want to use, or something like that, you can paste in a link here and it will grab that music from that. I'm just gonna go ahead and use a royalty-free one, but you can use whatever song you want. So there's a lot you can do on here. I recommend you just play around a little bit. We have tons of tutorials. So yeah, when you're done, you can just click the export video button. And then when the video is done processing, you can click the download button and then just go ahead and post it on Facebook Reels. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. Make sure to subscribe to the channel to join an online community of modern creators. Also check out our Discord so you can keep up with other Kapwingers and the Kapwing staff. And I'll see you guys in the next one.